verification of KVL and KCL. So we already studied that KVL is nothing but in a closed path, the algebraic sum of voltages is equal to zero. So that means source voltage is equal to the voltage drops in the particular closed path. So for that, I'm taking a simple circuit to explain the KVL. So this is a simple circuit I'm taking here. I applied a DC source. So this is 220 volts DC source I have applied, and I have taken three resistors, 150 ohms, and this is 100 ohms, and this is 200 ohms. This is a closed path. So application of KVL, Kirchhoff voltage law, we have to check whether the drops occurred in these three resistors is equal to the source voltage or not. So for this we can apply voltage division principle. So here I am applying voltage division principle across resistor 1, that means across 150 ohms resistor. So this is voltage across 150 ohms is equal to total voltage, source voltage into that particular resistor 150 divided by the total resistors. So I can write here 150 plus 100 plus 200. So this can be 33,000 divided by 450, so which is nothing but after calculating 73.33 volts. So similarly at resistor R2, that means at 100 ohms resistor, voltage across 100 ohms resistor can be written as same formula I'm applying, total source voltage into the particular resistor divided by the total resistors 450. So this could be 22,000 divided by 450, which can be written as 48.88 volts. So similarly, voltage across resistor R3, that means 200 ohms resistor. So V300 ohms can be written as same formula, 220 into 200 divided by 450. So I can have the value of 44,000 divided by 450. So this is around 97.77 volts. So here, this 150 ohm resistor is blocking this 73.33 volts, and this 100 ohm resistor is blocking 48.88 ohms volts, and this 200 ohms resistor is blocking 97.77 volts. So as per KVL, this algebraic sum of all the drops should be equal to this 220 volts. So 73.33 plus 48.88 plus 97.77, so which is almost equal to the 220 volts. Okay, so it is coming around 299. So 220 is equal to 220 volts. So hence the verification of KVL is done. Open the MATLAB account, and there we are having Simulink option. After pressing on Simulink option, a new window will be opened, and there we need to select a blank model, and from that we have to select the different elements such as active sources and passive elements. So as we are discussing the DC effect, so I have selected a DC voltage source and a series RLC branch, and from then I have changed that series RLC branch to a single resistance value, and I'm mentioning the value of 150 ohm resistor, and I have taken remaining three resistors, just hold and drag and change the values as we have taken as 100 ohm resistor and this one is the 200 ohm resistor. Simply connect that all the three elements with the DC voltage source. So I'm giving 220 volts DC supply, and to know the voltage across each and every resistor, I'm putting the voltage measurement block there. It will be calculating the voltage across resistor. So I'm applying for all the three elements. To know the value, I am taking a display block for each and every voltmeter. So I am just connecting it to the output port of the voltmeter. Similarly for remaining two voltage blocks also. Just increasing the font size of the blocks, so you can do the modifications as per the requirement. So add a power give component to make the simulation active. Then run the simulation for 0.6 seconds and wait for the results. Resistor 1 drops a voltage of 73.33 volts, resistor 2 drops 48.89 volts, and resistor 3 drops 97.78 volts. So if you add all these three voltages, it will be equal to the source voltage. Next one is KCL, Kirchhoff current law, verification of KCL. Kirchhoff current law states that the algebraic sum of currents in a particular node is equal to zero. That means entering currents is equal to leaving currents. So we need to verify this KCL. For that I am taking this circuit. The same resistance values I am considering here, which we have considered in KVL application. So here this is 220 volts and here 150 ohms, 100 ohms and 200 ohms. So to find out this, first of all we need to calculate total current flowing through the circuit. So here R equivalent value will be, it can be calculated as 1 by R equivalent is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So here 1 by R equivalent can be written as 1 by R1 is 150 ohms plus R2 is 100 ohms plus R3 is 200 ohms. So if I calculate this one, my R equivalent value will be 46.16 ohms. So if I know R equivalent value and I know voltage which we have applied here, then the total current will be 220 divided by this 46.16 ohms, which can be 4.766 amperes. So this is the total current flowing through the circuit, which is nothing but 4.766. So here this current, this is the entering current, and all these three are the leaving currents. So these leaving current should be equal to this entering current I total, which is equal to 4.766. So we need to verify this one. So for that I am taking current division principle. Current division principle. So current flowing through this 150 ohms will be equal to total current into parallel resistance to that 150 ohms divided by summation of all the resistance, or we can take like 150 plus this parallel resistance which we are considering in the numerator. So for that I have to calculate this total current is 4.766 into parallel resistance, means this two resistance in combination, that means these two are in parallel and this equivalent resistance is in parallel with the 150 ohms. So I can write like this. So equivalent value of these two parallel resistances, 100 into 200 divided by 100 plus 200. So the effective resistance here, the parallel combination of these two resistance. So I have taken this as a combination of these two resistance, and total resistance means this 150 plus this equation, this value which we are calculating here, the combination of these two which are in parallel. So this is the way to calculate the current division principle. So currents flowing in a particular branch. So in this can be now 1.766 into, so this combination I can write like 85.714 divided by, so this is 66.66 divided by 216.66. So this can be written as I150 is equal to 317.70 divided by 216.66, which can be written as 1.46 amperes. This value is 1.46. And second case, current flowing through 100 ohms. Same formula I'm applying. Total current is 4.766 into the parallel combination of 150 and 200. 150 and 200. It will be 85.714 divided by this parallel combination of 150 and 200 plus this 100 ohms resistor. So 100 plus 85.714. So this can be written as 408.512 divided by 185.714. This can be 2.19 ampere. And the third case, current flowing through 200 ohms is equal to 4.7666 into parallel combination of these two. So that can be So example, I will calculate here 150 into 100 divided by 250. This is a parallel combination divided by 200 plus 150 into 100 by 250. So here this entire value will be 4.766 into 60 by 260, which can be written as 1.09 ampere. So this is 2.19 and this is 1.09. So if we add these three, that should be equal to the total current. I total should be equal to I 150 ohms plus I 100 ohms plus I 200 ohms. So this is 4.766, which is equal to 1.46 plus 2.19 plus 1.09. So the total value is here 4.74 amperes. So entering current is equal to leaving current. So that, like that, we can verify the KCL. For verification of KCL, I'm taking the same three resistors which we have used in KVL, and I have connected all these three resistors in parallel connection with the same voltage source, 220 volts. In the KCL, we are measuring the currents, branch currents. So I'm taking current measurement. For three branch currents, three displays will be there, and to measure the total current, we are taking another block there, and that will be measuring the total current flowing through the circuit. So in the first display, we will be getting the total current. In the second one, we will be getting the current flowing through resistor 150 ohm, and in the third one, current flowing through the resistor 100 ohm, and in the fourth one, current flowing through the resistor 200 ohm. If we add these three currents, that means current flowing through 150 ohm, 100 ohm and 200 ohm will be equal to the total current which is flowing through the circuit.